Praise and honor be to the name of the Lord. The Lord bless you in Jesus' name. Amen. My name is Samuel E. Molombe, if you're seeing me for the very first time. And probably this video just popped up on your timeline. Probably you're just seeing this face and maybe you've never seen me before. There's a high probability that the Lord is drawing you to my ministry and God wants you to hear this prophetic word that He has given to me. Make sure you subscribe to be connected to more of God's blessings through His word. I'm going to be joining my faith with you, praying for you daily, and also telling you exactly what the Lord said. I'm responding to emails at least within 24 hours. No matter how many thousand emails I receive, I'm responding to them at most, rather, within 24 hours. At most, you are going to get a response from me. Direct prophecy, direct answer, direct prayer. Make sure you subscribe and make sure that you ring the notification bell and be notified when I'm live. Thank you for all of you that are always coming back to watch. God bless you in Jesus' name. Amen. I was just praying. I woke up this morning and I was praying and the Lord said for me to tell His children. He says, tell my child. This is a precise, direct, and very straightforward prophetic word. It's not for you if you don't feel it resonating in your spirit. I want you to check your inner mind and just verify if God is talking to you through this prophetic word. And if yes, make sure that you connect yourself to it by all means. God says, get ready to move. Get ready to move. Hallelujah. God says, pack your bags, get ready to move. In the book of 2 Samuel, chapter 9, the Bible tells us about a young boy called Mephibosheth. And I like that story particularly because it's a story of grace. How God shows grace to His creation. How God shows mercy to His people. Mephibosheth was the son of Jonathan. And Jonathan was a covenant friend to David. Mephibosheth was the son of Jonathan and Jonathan was a covenant friend to David. Jonathan and his father, King Saul, went for battle, and the Bible says that they died in battle. They died that day in battle. And it was a sad day for all of Israel because the king had died. Now, in those days, the tradition was when a king dies, the opponents come and kill all the members of the royal family. But even if they don't kill them, the successor of the king, the new king, will kill the royal family so that there will be nobody that will rise up in that the former king's family to defeat him while he is reigning. It was a strategy to maintain peace and tranquility in the land. When they heard the news of the death of Saul and Jonathan, they made the nanny of Mephibosheth, because Mephibosheth was 5 years old as of the time. She was in haste to run away with the child, grabs the child, and the child falls down and breaks his legs, and he became crippled for life. Mephibosheth grew and became, a full-grown man. And the Bible says that he just was staying in the land of Lodebar. Lodebar means a place of nothingness. Lodebar means out of the mouth of shame. Oh, Mephibosheth that was born to be in the palace was now relocated to Lodebar, a place of nothingness. Nothing was happening in his life. Nothing was going on for him. Not married, not with kids, just there. Born into royalty, but suffering like a peasant. The Bible says one day, the grace of God shone through the man David. And he said, is there anybody in the house of Saul that I might show mercy, I should show kindness for Jonathan's sake? Normally, David became the new king, but he did not want to kill the people in the house of Saul. He decided to show them mercy because of his covenant friend Jonathan. Now that is where Ziba came. Ziba was one of the servants of Saul. Ziba said to David, there is a young lad, there's a boy, there's a man who is called Mephibosheth. He's lame in his feet, he's crippled in his feet. And he was the son of Jonathan. This is how David adopted Mephibosheth, brought him back to Jerusalem, kept him in the king's yard, and he ate on the same table with the king again. That's the story that the Lord brought, and God says that that story is going to resonate with you, because right now, yes, you are born great. Yeah, you have so many untapped potential. There are so many things within you. You are an amazing lady, beautiful lady. You are an handsome guy, awesome character, but you are in the low deba. You are in your low deba, a place of nothingness. There's nothing going on in your life right now. Job is not working. Relationship is not working. The marriage is crushing. I mean, everything, and you just feel like I'm losing my mind. God says, I should tell you, get ready to move. You have entered into your season when He will introduce your Ziba. Because your Ziba will speak about you before great men. You are going to move from that place of sadness and depression and pain and distress and disease and mental and physical, financial dependence. You are going to get out of that place where you are crippled. Crippled means that you cannot assist yourself. You cannot help yourself. You cannot do anything for yourself. God says, get ready to move. This is your season. You managed to get out of that. You managed to, you know, stay alive. You've managed to stay alive. Now God is going to come with the push of grace. What is grace? I've always said grace is the involvement of God in your race. Now I want you to comment in this, comment down below and say, grace is the involvement of God in my race. Say, God, grace is God in my race. Grace is going to carry you. The hand of God is about to come to you. Glory to God. Remember, I'm speaking prophetically to someone. The grace of God is about to carry you. God, I'm about to tell you. Oh my God, I feel the anointing of God as I'm recording this word now. The grace of God is going to carry you to your high places in life. In the book of Revelation chapter 12, the Bible says, and to the woman was given the two great wings of an eagle, where she flew to her place of rest. The Lord said, as I should be the one that announces to you that you have entered into your season when you are going to move from Lodeba to Bethlehem. Bethlehem is the house of bread. You're going to move from Lodeba to Zion. You're going to move from Lodeba, the place of nothingness, to Zion, the place of the wealth of God, the city of the Lord, to the place where God dwells, to the place where favor resides, to the place where blessings reside. Glory to God. You have been crying before. Get ready to laugh. This is your season. And I want to comment down and say, this is my season. I receive it and I walk into it. I walk into it. Now, if you're commenting below, I am going to see that comment and join my faith and pray for you. That's why I want you to just, you know, tap there right down below. My email is in the description. Just tell me how this word is resonating with you. Tell me what the Lord is doing as you are hearing this word. Because God told me, and I believe it, it is your season. And He said, I should pray for you. I should be the midwife. The midwife that assists you birth that baby. Glory to God. The midwife that assists you birth that process, that transition. You know, there are people who come to help you move. I have come as a servant of the Lord with the message of God in my mouth to tell you, get ready, you are moving. Pack your bags, you are moving. Don't die in Lodeba. Don't die in Lodeba. Don't die in Lodeba. Comment and say, I will not die in Lodeba. Glory to God. Don't die in Lodeba. Your season to move is come. He says, get ready to move. Father, in the name of Jesus, I pray for your child now. You have spoken to him directly. Now I declare, your hand comes upon him, carries him to his high place. In the name of Jesus, you are blessed of God. You are moving from that low debar, the place of nothingness, the place of shame, distress, and disease. You are entering into your place of rest. May the wings of an eagle be given to you, that you should fly to your place of rest. In the name of Jesus, you are blessed of God. You are blessed of God. I rebuke the demons that are responsible to scatter your efforts and scatter your labors. I rebuke those demons. In the name of Jesus, you are blessed of God and your favor. In Jesus' name. Amen. On the description of this video, I have my email there. Make sure you write me, and I have more information there for those of you who want to connect yourself with this word. There at description, there are information on how you can connect to this word amazingly. The Lord bless you and keep you and cause His face to shine on you. You are leaving the place of emptiness in Jesus' name. Amen. I will see you in the next video. Praise God.